नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्ते सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै शांति 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 ही यो ब्रह्मांड विधाति पूर्व वेदागच्छ प्रहिनोति तस्मै तव महादेवात्मनि प्रकाश मोक्षुर्वै शरणम हम प्रपद्ये शांति 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 ही श्री चिद्घन गणेश सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठान बुद्धि 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 पारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेवाहं नमत्वन्यतिति मे निश्चितामतिः विराट रूपस्य विश्वस्य सप्तांगानि सन्ति दिस उपासना इज गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द पाद चतुष्टय बीइंग कॉमन अक्रॉस व्यष्टि एंड समष्टि सो विराट रूपस्य विश्वस्य सप्तांगानि सन्ति द्यौः स्वर्गलोकः शिरः सो देयर आर फोर सॉरी सेवन कंपोनेंट्स यू कैन सी इन विराट स्वर्गलोक इज हिज शिरः सूर्यः चक्षुः वायुः प्राणः आकाश उरह समुद्रादि रूपम जलम मूत्रस्थानम इट्स कॉल्ड बस्ती इन दी उपनिषद व्हेन इट एक्सप्लेन्स दिस उपासना पृथ्वी पादौ दी फीट आर दी पृथ्वी एंड देन आहवनीय होमादिकरण अग्नि ही मुखम सो आहवनीय अग्नि इज हिज मुख सो दिस इज हाउ वन शुड डू उपासना विराट पुरुष हु इज नॉट प्रत्यक्ष गोचर शुड बी imagined as being in this manner the all pervasive tattva is known as the samashti with a shira in this swarga swarga is his shira and then surya chakshu elsewhere it will be says surya and chandra are chakshu so here specifically based on the upasana one has to do the dhyana there how it is based on the vidhi one has to do the dhyana therefore upasana is based on the vidhi it is not on karta's choice any other things are quite clear there iti etani sapta vishvasya angani and you look at this it is this vishwa at the individual level who has to be doing ahangra upasana thinking about himself as virat So my shiraha is swargaloka. My chakshu is surya. This is how one should imagine. Dyuloka adini yadyapi na vishvasya angani tathapi virajaha angani bhavanti tasya virajaha vishvena abheda asti. Since vishwa and virat are just vyashti and samashti differences and that we cannot say just, it is a huge difference. But still there is no difference because it is all upadhi krita bheda. If one sees differences in upadhi, then one may think that I am a limited person. Therefore, the upasana bridges that gap of upadhi also, thinking of his upadhis as my upadhi. Finally, you want to land on that tattva, which is upadhi rahita, whether in vyashti or samashti. So whether I take this upadhi, that upadhi, at an individual level or at a universal level, it is just upadhi bheda. Whether it is my sharira or other sharira, between jiva and jiva also the bheda is by sharira. If I had that kind of a body, you know, when you look at a person and you appreciate, you know, maybe, you know, there are people who do that, you know, because that's why there is this idol worship of, you know, actors and all that, you know. Mr. Universe, you know, Miss Universe, whatever this is, people start appreciating the beauty or the sharira outside and think that, you know, I can also become like that. And then there are these advertisements based on, I mean, these people who have their beauty appreciated, they advertise it so that the others who are wanting to become that use it. But you see, I think that with that body, I will be like that person. So even at a subtle level, even an ignorant, an ajnani knows that there is no difference within. It is just difference outside. Had I had that kind of a body, I would have also been like that. And at a slightly subtler level, you know, oh, he plays amazing chess, you know, what a brain. If I had that kind of a brain, at a physical level, it's not really a brain that we are talking about. At a physical level, it's brain. But what we are saying that? The content, the mind. What a mind, you know. The person has an excellent intellect. Had I had that kind of an intellect. So I know that I am different from that intellect. I have a different intellect, but I am not the intellect. At a subtler level, I do know. Even an ignorant knows. Therefore, if I had that kind of an intellect, there would be no difference is what I'm trying to see there. When I train my mind, when I use puzzles or, you know, I solve these Rubik's cubes, whatever, what I'm trying to do is that bridge that upadhi gap. And in upasana, I can do it with any upadhi, which is creating difference. Even in this upasana, I can take on the samashti upadhi, and then see if I had that kind of a samashti sharira, I would be no different than Virat. And since the samashti sharira is also created by the same basic components through which my sharira is created, there is really no bheda at that level also, except for that qualitative bheda, quantitative bheda. And in upasana, I can bridge that gap also. Tasya virajaha vishvena abheda asti. Dyulokadini yadyapina vishvasyangani tathapi. With this jhana, I can bridge that gap. Virajaha angani bhavanti. Tasya virajaha vishvena abheda asti. Tasmat mandukya upanishadi vishvangatvena tani uktani. So you have to look at the mandukya prakriya where you are not the ansha of Virat. Virat is your Ausha. He is one Pada. So, Tasmad Mandukya Upanishadi Vishwangatvena Tani Uktani. Although there are four Padas at Samashti and Vashti level, still the Upasaka is the Jiva. It is not the Samashti who wants Mukti. I want Mukti as a Vashti. I want Mukti. So, all the angas are to be imagined as mine, my angas, not as samashti angas. I don't merge myself with the samashti. In Mandukya Prakriya, I merge the samashti into myself, the vyasti. Evam viradatmaka vishvasya ekona yushati mukhani santi. There are 19 mukhas said to be in Mandukya Upanishad at the stula as well as sukshma level. Pranaha pancha, karmindriyani pancha, jnanendriyani pancha. Antakkarana chatushtayam ityetani mukhani. So 5 pranas, 5 karmindriyas, 5 jnanendriyas, total to 15. And then antakkarana has 4. Manaha, buddhi, chitta and ahankara. Thereby 19. So Tippana says, sakala prani sharireshu aham ityabhimana karanat Ishwaraha Vaishwanara iti kathyate. Why is Ishwara called as Vaishwanaraha? Because he is the aham abhimani in each and every sharira. Ahantaya vartate. Vividham rajate anekada prakashate iti sahaiva Vaishwanara virat iti abhidiyate. So virat, this rajru deeptav dhatu is used here. Virat. Vividham rajate. The same Ishwara shines forth in various manners. Therefore, he is called as Vaishwanaraha. Sakala jivanam karmanusarana phaladanat Ishwaraha iti nama. Ishwara, this Ishwaratvam is overlordship because he rules over others and decides as to what is the phala to be given based on the karma, individual karmas. Sukshma deha abhimana aparityagena eva stula dehe aham iti abhimanavan jagrat abhimani jivaha vishwa ityuchate. Vishwa is jagratsthana abhimani, jagrat avastha abhimani. When he has abhimana in stula deha is me. When he wakes up to the jagrat avastha, the sukshma deha sambandha is already there. So there is an additional abhimana in the stula deha. So aparityagena, stula deha abhimana aparityagena. Without giving up the stula deha, sukshma deha abhimana, stula deha is an add-on. Abhimana there is an add-on. There he is called as Vishwa. That kind of an entity, Jiva, is called as Vishwa. Tejas shabda vachyanta karana sahita pranendriyadhyaksha swapna abhimani jiva tejas aitya vivete. We know this. Prajnya pra purvaka ajnya. So what is this pra? Pra purvaka ajnya becomes prajnya by savarna dirga sandhi. Sushupti kale swaprakashatma anandena saha ajnana vrtehe ajnana vrtehe sattvat sushuptyabhimani jivaha prajnya iti kirtyate. Why is called as prajnya? Because there is swaprakashatvam. The pra is showing the swaprakashatvam of the ananda which is there in sushupti avastha, which is one's own swarupa ananda and one's own spurana. Since the ajnana vritti also continues, therefore avarna continues, therefore he is ajna also. So pra shows the swaprakasha and ananda swarupa, whereas ajnyatvam is due to ajnana vritti continuing in the sushupti avastha. Okay, so that is the Mandukya Upanishad as a basis for this upasana which has been described. Bhogasya sadhana bhutatvat mukhani ityuchyante. Why are these 19 components called as mukhas, panchapranas ityadi? Bhogasya sadhana bhutatvat. Mukha is what faces. So you say face. Face is that faces towards something. But mukha specifically also means partaking something. It can mean both ways. So it is bridge. It is acting as a bridge towards something, as a sadhana, as a means. Therefore, bhogasya sadhana bhutatvat mukhani, indriyani. And then the antakkarana also, karanani. Basically, karanani. Indriyas as karanani, prana which helps these indriyas function, and then the antakkarana which is backing all the indriyas and makes them do what they do. Jagradavasthayam etaihi ekonavimshati mukhaihi stula shabdas shabdadayaha bahya vritya anubhuyante. So whether in jagradavastha, through these 19 mukhas, stula shabdadayaha, so stula shabdasparsha rupa rasa gandha, those are experience anubhuyante. How? Bahya vritya. We have seen this, the vritti vyapti ityadi. So the vritti goes outside and then there is anubhava of the shabda sparsha ityadi. Tasmad virad rupa vishwa stula bhuk iti bahya vritti riti jagrad avasthaha iti cha kathyate. Therefore, the same virat who is vishwa is called as stula bhuk. So stulam bhunkte iti stula bhuk. In that avastha, in jagrat avastha, Vishwa experiences sthula. Therefore, is called as sthula bhuk. Bahya vrittihi. So, bahya vrittayaha yasya vishwasya saha vishwaha bahya vrittihi. So, using bahurihi, he is also called as bahya vritti. Who has bahya vritti is called as bahya vritti. Who has jagrat avastha is called as jagrat avastha. It will become pullinga. Because Vishwa is pullinga. So, jagrat avastha, yasya vishwasya sa vishwa, jagrat avastha, iti cha kathyate. Chaturdasha triputyaha. Now, there are triputis. We know triputi as what? The karta, karana, and karma bheda. So, jnyatru, jnaya, jnana bheda. This is a triputi, which is the vritti bheda really in the antakkarana. They are 14 types. So Chaturdasha Tripudiya. So we'll just quickly go through this. What are these three triads? There are 14 triads which are talked about here. Bhoga sadhaneshu pranadishu ekona yushati mukheshu shrotradi dashendriyani antakkarana chatushtayam chaiti chaturdasha mukhani swasva vishayanam sahayam swasva devatanam cha sahayam apekshante. So whatever is a bhoga sadhana, what are those? Pranadi, karmendriyas, jnanendriyas and antakkarana chatushtaya. These are the ekona yushati mukhas, 19 mukhas. So bhoga sadhaneshu mukheshu ekona yushati mukheshu shrotradi dashendriyani. So this shrotra ite shrotradi dashendriyani and antakkarana chatushtayam. Prana is also there. So pancha prana and then these dashendriyas and antakkarana chatushtaya total to 19. Chaturdasha mukhani swasva vishayanam sahayam swasva devatanam cha sahayam apekshante. There are adishthatru devatas for each of these 14 mukhas. And then devata vishayoho sahayam mantara kevalaihi etaihi chaturdasha mukaihi bhoga na sambhavati. Just because one has indriyas or these mukhas, sadhanas, bhoga is possible cannot be said. People have indriyas but still they are not working well. Sometimes non-functional completely. Because adishthatru devatas are not blessing them. So just because indriyas are there, devatas lacking or devatas anugraha lacking or vishayas lacking. So both are mentioned here. Devata vishayoho sahaya mantara. Without the sahaya of the vishayas and adishthatru devatas, indriyas cannot function. Therefore, the chaturdasha mukha will not lead to bhoga. Kevalaihi. Tasmat pancha pranaha chaturdasha triputyascha virad rupa vishvasya mukhani ityuchyante. So these are called as Virat's mukhas because Virat is the devata, real devata there, who manifests as the adishthatru devata. Sacha triputi evam varnyate. Sorry. Mukham devata visheshcha iti trayanam samuhasya triputi iti nama. So there is a devata needed, there is vishaya needed, and there is mukha, which is the karana, indriya, prana, or the antakkarana chatushtaya. So thus mukhas or indriyas become the karanas. Devata is present. In fact, devata himself is as though karta there. And then vishaya is the karma. So that is your triputi now. Now these triputis vary across. Vary as in the triad is the same, similar, but then based on these 14 which are talked about, there are triads which are having slight differences. Trayanam samuhasya triputi iti nama. So triputi is the triad of these mukha, devata and vishaya. So it's mentioned in a different manner so that you can see the vyashti and samashti both in one triad. Generally when you look at jnatru jnaya and jnana bheda, kartru karma and karana bheda, that time in that triputi it will be only at an individual level. Here you can see the abheda at the samashti level also, because mukha is your own, vishaya is outside jagat, and then devata, you are not devata. Generally we don't think ourselves as devata. So devata is samashti, mukha is belonging to the vyashti, and vishaya is the prapancha, which is the karya created by jagat, created by Ishvara. So Ishvara is jagat karta, manifest as devata here, Virat. Mukha is at the vyashti level, jiva, so aham. Here you can look at the samashti and vyashti included. Then samashti as a karya also. Jagat is Ishvara karya, so you can see those vishayas also, prapancha. So all three which you are inquiring into can be seen in this triputi itself. You don't see this otherwise. You see vishaya, okay, vishaya is there. That vishaya is individualized. And then you have your own indriyas and then you are the karta. There is no samashti in play when you look at the Triputi in general, but here you look at the Triputi where you see all three components of Prapancha, Ishvara and Jiva together in one Triputi, and this Triputi can be seen in all the 14 sets. Sacha Triputi evam varnyate. What are these 14? So I'll just read these, and I don't think there is much there to look at, but this helps us see in all sorts of triads we can see the whole. We can see Prapancha, Prapancha Karta, and I who am a samsari. All three parts are seen. Shrotrendriya, Shrotrendriyam Adhyatmam, Tadvishya Shabda Adhibhutam, Digabhimanini Devata Adhidaivam. So in this Adhyatma, Adhibhuta and Adhidaiva, that triad, there you see Shrotrendriya is Adhyatma, Shrotrendriya, and then Shabdaha is what? Adhibhuta. Digabhimanini Devata. So Adhishtatru Devata is Digdevata. Digdevata means he has Abhimana in Dik, in the directions. Thereby that Devata blesses the Shrotrendriya so that it can consume the Shabda as Vishaya. This is the reason Adhibhuta Devata, Adhishtatru Devata, my apologies, I'm making quite a few mistakes. Somehow, quite a lot of noise around. Still, the speakers are going on. So, Shrotrendriya is Adhyatma. So, at the individual level, I can see only this much. Vishaya, something which is outside. So, subject-object division is what I can see. But then, once I bring in the Adhishtatru Devata, without whom the Shabda cannot exist, without whom the Shrotrendriya cannot function, then that is bridging the subject-object together into a triad, which I can see from the Advaita angle now. Thereby, this Digabhimanini Devata is blessing the Shrotrendriya Adhyatma by becoming Adhidaiva, Adhishtatru Devata, and thereby Shabda Vishaya Adhibhuta becomes known. Atra Kriya Shakti Jnana Shakti Bhyam Yukta. So Kriya Shakti Jnana Shakti Bhyam Yuktani Indriyani Antakkarana Cha Adhyatma Mityuchyate. So here you look at the Shrotrendriya. The Shrotrendriya by itself cannot do anything. We have seen earlier because Vishaya and Adhishtatru Devata are needed. But also, Shrotrendriya itself cannot function even on the individual side. You also need the Antakkarana. So, Antakkarana is included. The Indriyas has Kriya Shakti. Of course, Prana also has to be there. Kriya Shakti is due to Prana. Jnana Shakti is also possible due to Indriya. So, Indriyas backed by Prana have Kriya Shakti, and Jnana Shakti is also the role of the Jnanendriya. So, Kriya Shakti, Jnana Shakti, Bhyam Yuktani Indriyani, Antakkaranam Cha Adhyatma Mityuchyate. All these are a set even in the Shrotrendriya, which is Adhyatma. There also, lot of other components are playing along. Tesham Vishaya Adhibhutam Iti Kirtyate. Tesham Sahaya Bhuta Devataha Adhidaivam Iti Abhidiyate. It is very clear. So, Indriya Vishayas are called as Adhibhuta. Indriyas along with the Antakkarana and the Prana also, we have to read in Kriya Shakti and Jnana Shakti also. That kind of a set of Indriyas are called as Adhyatma. Adhibhuta is their own Vishayas. And then Sahaya Bhuta, those which are going to help. Those Adhishtatru Devatas are called as Adhidaivam. Now this has been dealt with in one, it will extend to the others. So other points are shorter. Tvagindriyam Adhyatmam Tadvishayas Parsha Adhibhutam Vayu Abhimanini Devata Adhidaivam. So Adhishtatru Devata for Sparsha is Vayu. Tvagindriya is Adhyatma. I'll just read this. This is very clear. So the Adhishtatru Devata is mentioned. We already know the Vishaya for which indriya, which is the vishaya. So we know adhyatma and adibhuta. We'll just look at the devatas also, which have been mentioned earlier. And we have seen in other granthas like Tattva Bodha Ityadi. So I'll just read these for completion sake. Netrendriyam adhyatmam, rupam adibhutam, suryaha adidaivam, rasendriyam adhyatmam, rasa adibhutam, varunaha adidaivam, ghranendriyam adhyatmam, gandha adibhutam, ashwini kumara, kumarau, ashwini kumarau, they are two. So there are two devatas who are adidaivam for ghranendriya. Athava prithvyabhimanini devata adidaivam. So there is an option there. Prithvi or Ashwini Kumaru. Based on the Grantha Bhedas, it is mentioned Vagendriya Madhyatmam, Vaktavya Madhibhutam, Agni Devata, Adidevam. So here Ashwini Kumaru and Prithvi, it's mentioned here in the Tippana, it is said Suryashvasya, Ghranabhyam Ashwini Kumarayoho, Utpatti Varnanath, Ghrana Devate, Ashwini Kumaru iti Kechanahu. So there is a difference as to, you know, in Grantha, so Kechan Ahu, that is the difference there. Prithivyaha Ghranasya Utpannatvat Prithivyabhimanini Devata Ghrana Devata iti Vartika Kara Ahu. So Vartika Kara says Prithivi is the Ghrana Adishtatru Devata, whereas Suryashvasya Ghranabhyam Ashwini Kumarayoho Utpatti Varana. So the Ashwini Kumaras have a particular Utpatti, therefore they being, you know, Vitpanna from Ghrana, they are called as Ghrana Devata. Vachana Kriyaha Vishaya Bhuta Padartha Vaktavyam Iti Chate. So, Vachana Kriyaha Kriyayaha Vishaya Bhuta Padartha. The tongue plays the role of tasting as well as uttering something. So, that utterance that the tongue does as a Karmendriya, that is called as Vaktavyam. सह वचन क्रिया द्वारा वागेन्द्रियस्य अधिभूतम् एवं एव सर्वेन्द्रियाणां स्वस्व क्रिया द्वारा विषयभूतः पदार्थः अधिभूतमिति ज्ञेयम्. सो वचन क्रिया द्वारा वागेन्द्रियस्य अधिभूतम्, दैट इज हाउ दि वक्तव्यम बिकम्स अधिभूतम् एंड एवमेव सर्वेन्द्रिय, इट हैज टू बी एक्सटेंडेड टू दि अदर्स आल्सो. क्वचित् तु स्थूल दृष्ट्या Vachanadi, must be Vachanadi Kriya Eva Adhibhutam Ityuchyate. So sometimes in some places, some of them, they talk about Kriya itself as Stula Drushtya. Looking at the Kriya, they talk about this Vachanadi Kriya itself as Adhibhutam, not the Vishaya. So in the triad also, interpretation wise, there is some difference, because Karma and Kriya, sometimes they are used interchangeably also. But anyway, that detail is unnecessary detail, at least in this context. Further, Panindriyam Adhyatmam, Padartha Grahanam Adhibhutam, Indraha Adhidaivam, Padendriyam Adhyatmam, Gamanam Adhibhutam, Vishnuhu Adhidaivam, Payuhu Adhyatmam, Malavisarjanam Adhibhutam, Yamaha Adhidaivam, Upastendriyam Adhyatmam, Gramya Sukotpattihi, Maithuna Sukotpattihi Adhibhutam, Prajapatihi Adhidaivam, Manaha Adhyatmam, Mantavyam Sankalpaha, अधिभूतं चंद्रः अधिदैवं बुद्धिः अध्यात्मं बोद्धव्यं निश्चय अधिभूतं बृहस्पतिः अधिदैवं अहंकार अध्यात्मं अहंकर्तव्यं अधिभूतं रुद्रः अधिदैवं चित्तं अध्यात्मं चिंतनीयं अधिभूतं क्षेत्रज्ञः साक्षी अधिदैवं. एताः चतुर्दश त्रिपुट्यः पञ्चः प्राणाश्च मिलित्वा एतानि विराट रूपस्य विश्वस्य एकोनविंशति मुखानि. So out of the 19, 5 pranas are set aside, and then the other 14 we can see as having these triads, these triputis. And thereby one can inquire into each of these or think upon each of these during the dhyana itself, how Virad and Vishwa can be bridged. If it is not easy, then one can go to this granularity, this level of granularity, and then understand the Abheda at the Vyashti Samashti level, or bringing them together in the Triputis, through the Triputis, bringing them together. Now, just looking at this Triputis, how do you know that there is Abheda? How does it help understand Abheda? See, I am the one who am hearing. You take a simple example. I am the one who am hearing. Now, this Adhishthatru Devata is blessing or is within. That Adhishthatru Devata is within. Actually, as Karta himself, the Adhishthatru Devata is a specific manifestation of Ishvara who blesses the Indriyas, and another specific manifestation makes me a Shrota. And we know that the Vishaya is also, Shabda is also born out of the same Ishvara. Tasmad vaye tasmad atmana akasha sambhuta, that akasha is shabda gunavan akasha. So Vishaya is one particular manifestation of Ishvara. Adhishthatru Devata, who is blessing the Indriya, the Indriyas which are born out of Pancha Mahabhuta, which are born out of Ishvara, are a specific manifestation as Vishaya. And this Adhishthatru Devata, while blessing the Indriyas, who is the consumer really? The Karta Bhokta, Shrota Manta Ityadi. That is also a manifestation of Ishvara Ahamtaya. Therefore, all these three come together in the Triputi. This is how one can see that Abheda between Vyashti and Samashti. So Sakshi is Adidaivam. What is Sakshi here? You look at the Tippana. Sakshi Chaitanyam Chittasya Ashrayatvat Tasya Anugraham Karoti. So that Ishvara, who is Chaitanya Sarupa, is Sakshi Chaitanya at an individual level. Chittasya Ashrayatvat Tasya Chittasya Anugraham Karoti. Kasa or Kim? Because neuter. Sakshi Chaitanyam. Tasma Sakshi Chaitanyam Chittasya Adidaivam Ityuchyate. Therefore, Sakshi Chaitanya is called as Chittasya Adhishthatru Devata. Just for understanding. Not really a Devata at all. Not an individual Devata at all, but as though individualized in Sakshi Chaitanya. In the term Sakshi Chaitanya. Atha eva kechana acharya chintana rupam smriti jnanam sakshyashritam ahuhu. And this is the basis on which others conclude that the chintana also or smriti also is what? Sakshyashritam. Kvachit chittasya adhidevam narayana vasudeva. Kvachit chittasya adhidevam narayana vasudeva ityuktam. So elsewhere it is mentioned that narayana is the adhidaiva for chitta. So either you look at as Sakshi Chaitanya or narayana. Either way, you should land on Abheda. Maybe Narayana will help more Vasudeva to see the Abheda at the Vyashti Samashti level. Okay, enough details there. Vishwa Virat Akara Matra. So Akara, Ukara, Makara, these are being looked into. And then Amatra. So there are three matras, Akara, Ukara, Makara, that make up Omkara. And in Pranava Upasana, you can look at the individual utterances of Akara, Ukara, Makara. Although Omkara is uttered with the Sandhi, Om. You should not say Om, Om. It should be Om. Sandhi is Nitya there. There, while one utters Omkara, one can imagine the Akara, Ukara, Makara and then think of them as Vishwatajasa or Vishwatajasa Prajna. And Amatra is Turiya. The silence after the utterance, after one closes the mouth, Om, and then Makara is at the end. The mouth is closed. There cannot be any utterance. You cannot utter anything with the mouth closed. That silence is Amatra. Vishwaha Virat Akara Matra Ityetesham Abheda Chintanam. So one can do Chintana of Abheda between Vishwa at the Vyashti level, Virat at the Samashti level, and Akara Matra in the Omkara. These three are also having Abheda. Virajaha Vishwasya cha Yatha Abhedaha Tatha Omkara Prathama Matrayaha Akarasya Virad Rupa Vishwena Saha Abheda Asti. So just like there is an Abheda between Virat and Vishwa, similarly ओंकारस प्रथम मात्रा विच इज अकारा मात्र है अकारस्य विराट रूप विश्वेन सह अभेद अस्ति. सो वी ऑलरेडी अंडरस्टूड दैट विराट रूप इज विश्व एंड दैट विश्व हैज अभेद विद अकार ऑफ ओंकार. तथा ही ब्रह्मण चतुर्षु पादेषु प्रथम पाद विराट आत्मनः चतुर्षु पादेषु प्रथम पाद विश्व ओंकारस्य मात्रात्मकेषु चतुर्षु पादेषु प्रथम पाद अकार. सो वी सी ब्रह्मण चतुर्षु पादेषु प्रथम पाद विराट एट दि समष्टि लेवल दि फर्स्ट पाद इज विराट एट दि व्यष्टि लेवल फर्स्ट पाद आउट ऑफ दि फोर इज विश्व एंड ओंकार ऑल्सो हैज फोर पादास अकार उकार मकरण अमात्र. सो फर्स्ट पाद अकार ऑल्सो is one with the first pada of the others. Trayanam esham aditva roopa dharma samanya sattvat vishva virad akaranam abhedam chintayet. And thereby trayanam esham aditva roopa dharma samanya sattvat. So some samanya is imagined there. This happens to be trayanamesham, Vishwa, Virat and Akaraha have aditva rupa dharma samanyam. This should be thought. There is aditya rupa dharma samanyam between Virat, Vishwa and Akara. Therefore, Vishwa, Virat, Akaranam abhedam chintaye. So you use something to bring in the samanyam. Now this is from the Shastras. So why Aditya Rupa? So Shastra says that, see, in Omkara it is easy. Akara is the first. Aditya. Akara is the first. And when you are counting the others, Stula, you start from Stula, they'll be first. Shastra says you start from Vishwa on the individual side and Virat on the Samashti side. So therefore, being Adi, Aditya Rupa Dharma Samanya Sattvat Vishwa Virat Akaranam Abhedam Chintayet. I may have said Aditya here, so Aditya. So being the first is the commonality between these three. And the if you start from Prajna, then we'll have trouble, but it has to start from Stula and go within. Thereby, Omkara Akara will fit in as the first, and then we can have Aikya Drishti, Abheda Drishti, basically. Ittham Vishwasya Saptangani Ekonimshati Mukhani Cha Vyakhyatani. So we have described, the 19 Mukhas of Vishwa. Then Vishwa Taijasayo Abheda, we look at it in the next part, how Vishwa is non-different from Taijasa at the individual level, and at the samashti level anyway Vishwa is non-different from Virat. So Virat has been collapsed with Akara, with the entire prapancha, stula prapancha and all the stula shariras into Vishwa. This Vishwa is to be collapsed in Tejasa into Tejasa. This Tejasa will have oneness with Hiranyagarbha, sukshma prapancha and sukshma sharira. Then this Taijasa will be merged into Prajna. That is the Prakriya. We'll look at it in the next part. Sukarnityam Suprakasham Vyapakan Namrupe Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhya Edarkyatvanim Aparam Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Parama Tadeva Annamatvam Minishchitamatihi. That's it. Namaste.
Hari Om.